Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna, Sri Krishna. Guru Brahma, Guru Vishnu, Guru Devo Maheshwaraha, Guru Sakshat Param Brahma, Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha, Tasmai Sri Gurave Namaha. If we are essentially divine, what is the reason that we do not remain in the divine poise and we suffer the life of relative existence? What is the reason? So the reason is called, it is innate power of the divine. It is something like this. Today also there is a lot of echo. If you can reduce the echo, it's better. There is no echo there. And I should go and sit there. So, because this echo is reflected in the camera very badly. Okay. So, what is the power because of which we conceal our own divinity? This power of the Lord is called as the Anva Mala. Anu. Anu means individual. Mala means impurity. Another question is, why God has His own power concealed? And the same thing has come in us also. Don't we conceal to the world what we are actually and what we present to the world? Actually we are, for example, corrupt. But to the world we show, oh, I am the most, you know, sincere person. We are cheating the world, but we show to the world, no, no, I am, see, from you I cannot take profit, my friend, you are my very close friend. From others I take, and even then the shopkeeper will take the profit. So this is our nature. So from the Lord Himself, He has this nature to conceal His own status. For what? Just for fun. There is no reason. So, this Paramatma, He as if conceals His nature, and because of that, He starts suffering the limitations of this incomplete knowledge. Up to here we have seen yesterday. Now the question comes, Kim idu anvo mala atma eva bandaha na itiya. Is it that only this innate power of the Supreme Reality is causing this limitation and covering the essential nature of the divine? He said, no, there are many more factors. Which are those factors? Yoni vargaha kala shariram. Yoni is the birthplace. Yoni. Kala shariram. Kala is the expansion, activity. So the infinite potentiality of Paramatma, called as the chit, and the expansion of that potentiality called as ananda, and expression of that ananda through the three powers called as the Ichcha Shakti, the Jnana Shakti and Kriya Shakti, all these put together create a sense of relativity, and the infinite is reduced to the finite. So Yoni Vargaha and Kala Shariram. Kala Shariram is all the activities. In short, starting from the five great elements, then the five Dhanendriyas, five Karmendriyas, Pancha Pranas, and their modification. They become so important for us that we forget our essential nature. See, for example, a person loses his eyesight. then what can happen? We become miserable throughout life. Oh God, why did you take my eyesight away? But a wise person will not get lost in that. He will continue his life with cheer and happiness. I know there is one boy in Bombay. He had some, you know, by birth defect in his eyes. Up to the age of 10th standard or 12th standard, he was perfectly all right. Extremely intelligent. Then for some reason, his retina detachment took place, so he can't see. But he didn't give up. He said, so what? And then he started telling his mother, you read for me. Tani used to listen. He can't read. And the mother also genius. Whenever she used to get time, she will record the whole text, reading slowly, and leave it for the son. And together he completed his engineering in software, then he did his MBA. Now he is a marketing person in a big company. So he goes everywhere with his attendant because he can't see anything. But he presents his thoughts so beautifully and earning a lot. But in his place, had there been someone all the time, oh God, why did you take away my vision and all that? In the same manner, instead of recognizing our own divine potentiality, we get so much influenced by the possessions and the relations. And we start imagining that all possessions is me, all relations is me. And then we carry the burden of the possessions and relations throughout life like a mule and suffer. See, friends. Therefore, what is the cause of this bondage is this. See, friend, just come to cognize this. When we talk about ourselves, what do we talk? We talk about our possessions. We talk about our relations. Possessions in the form of the material wealth or the achievements in the field wherever we are working. That is I. And second thing, the relations. Now drop these two things, possessions and relations. What remains is absolute self. And who is miserable in life? The one who was a possessor is miserable. Who is miserable in life? The one who was carrying the burden of relations. So the husband is miserable, the father is miserable, the mother is miserable, the daughter-in-law is miserable. These are all relations. They are not absolute. See, friends, this is what is causing the bondage. Yoni vargaha kala shariram. And then their activities. See? If my beloved is ill, I am frustrated. If somebody I lose, I become totally depressed. And we call ourselves wise. In fact, we are otherwise. Therefore, the cause of bondage is this incomplete knowledge gathered through the limitations of the sense organs and the mind and the intellect. And thereafter, we carry the burden of this incomplete knowledge that we have gathered in our life. And thus, such a person continues to live in this limited sphere as a limited being. And just analyze your experience. You know, one of the spiritual practices, according to Vedanta Shastra, is this. The mechanical spiritual practice is do yogasana, go for a walk, do pranayama, take the rosary in the hand and keep on chanting the mantra mechanically. The real spiritual practice is learn from your own experiences. That's all. For example, we have fulfilled so many desires in our life, right from childhood. Have we learned anything? If we learn, we'll come to know that we have fulfilled one desire, Did it give a stop? No. Second desire is standing behind that. You fulfill the second desire, does it stop? No. Third desire is in the queue. It never stops. And our whole life is a struggle to fulfill the desire. But we have never attained fulfillment in life. Now who can teach us? It is something like, you know, a person, a young boy, about 18 or 19, he died in Calcutta. He was having diabetes by birth. So, he was supposed to keep away from sugar. And he will eat, and then he became expert. He started taking injections and eat and take injections. So his parents asked me, Swamiji, please advise us what to do with this boy. With this he cannot survive. He goes and opens the fridge and takes whatever he wants. But we can't lock the fridge. As in, if you sincerely want, you will not ask this question. Don't bring any sweet in the house. You all will eat sweets. And tell that child, don't eat. How will he understand? See, friends. So the child knows it is detrimental, yet we keep on eating. So what is the logic behind it? Therefore, if we learn from our experiences that fulfillment of the desires is not equal to fulfillment in life. And what is required in life is fulfillment in life, not fulfillment of desires. And yet we have never learned. Therefore, isn't it we drop all our possessions and relations to discover the happiness? And for that purpose we go to sleep. Sleep is nothing but unloading the burden that we were carrying all through. When these ammas, they take out their purse, before they sit on the chair, they will take out the purse and install prana pratishtha, please sit down. What is the reason? The reason is, it's a burden that they were carrying. And when they put the purse down, very good. Exactly the same thing happens, we experience in deep sleep. What is deep sleep? All possessions are given up, we have nothing. All relations are given up, we are nobody. When we have nothing and we are nobody, happiness begins. It is not the happiness of possessions and relations, but it is the happiness of unloading the possessions and relations. Therefore, Yoni Varga Kala Shariram, this world of matter, its expansion leading into the relations and possessions is the cause of bondage in this world. When this is said, a question comes. Do you mean that we should also become Babaji like you, give up everything and start moving from door to door? No, you don't become. Don't take my market. Stay where you are. But only play the role. One lady was telling me in Delhi, Swamiji, I am envious of you. I said, continue, what can I do? Your life is so lovely, you go everywhere, this nice food, people respect you. I said, you come with me. She came to Jaipur. I said, only one condition you have to come. Whether you attend satsanga or not, I will not ask you. But you have to attend every breakfast, every lunch, every evening tea, every dinner. Yes, yes. For that only I want to come. Very good. Third day, she came and held my feet. Swamiji, please forgive me. If I will come, I will die. I said, never mind. You come now. See, my life is very comfortable, you know. Nice food everywhere I go. Try to eat rich food the whole life. You like rich food because you never get good food. Once in a blue moon, I have to suffer 3-4 meals a day. See, friends, the more you become aware of this, that we are unnecessarily carrying the burden of possessions and relations. Such a person is always in bondage. When you have to do anything, you know, these things I have learned from my experiences. See? Like I tell you, in Bombay, one of my friends has bought a flat for me. Very good flat. He says, Swamiji, inside whatever you want to do, you do it according to your choice. I will not ask you any question. So I never like things hanging on the wall. Wall should be free. And all the, your furniture should be at the, you know, table level. So you feel open. He said, do whatever you like. And then I went for getting, you know, the type of furniture and the tabletop, everything. During those days, almost a month or two, I have never even thought of Bhagavad Gita, Upanishad, chanting the Lord's name, sitting for meditation. All the time only that thing was going in the hand, in the head. Oh, this you should be done, you should be done. Paramatma gone. That day I decided, now onwards, nowhere getting involved in anything. This is spiritual practice. So what is the sleep? Sleep is an attempt to disown the possessions and relations. So in the waking state, how do we do? Play the role that you are supposed to play. That's it. Now the next step comes. So, ajnanam bandaha, incomplete knowledge is bondage. Then the incomplete knowledge leads to the sense of possessions and relations, that is also the cause of bondage. Now the third thing. What is the foundation of this incomplete knowledge? The foundation of incomplete knowledge is jnana adhisthanam matruka. Jnana adhisthanam. The knowledge is supported by standing on matruka. Matruka means the unknown potentiality is matruka. We all have infinite potentiality, but we do not know our own potentiality. See, friends. Now here is a very deep subject. Before I take to the subject, I'll just give you one understanding about this whole thing. You all must have visited Kali Mata's temple sometime or the other, seen the pictures. In that, Kali Mata is bringing her tongue out, and there is a garland of human heads, skulls. And they are not the skulls, they are the heads. And then she is standing on Lord Shiva. This is the picture. So those heads are nothing but the 50 alphabets of Sanskrit. A, A, E, E, U, U, A, I, O, O, M, A, K, K, G, G, A, C, C, J, J, T, T, D, 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 T, T, D, D, N, P, P, B, B, M, Y, R, L, V, S, S, K, S, H. Starting from A up to H. This is the Varnamala. These are the alphabets in Sanskrit language. And the tongue comes out. These alphabets by themselves, they don't exist. They are supported by the tongue, means the speech. And the speech is existing at four levels. The speech by which I talk to you is called as Vaikari Vani. When we talk to ourselves, others don't listen, it is called as Madhyama Vani. When the speech has not started manifesting, but there is a potentiality to manifest, it is called as the Pashyanti Vani. And when it is unmanifest with complete potentiality in a dormant state, it is called as Paravani. These are the four stages through which the knowledge passes. So, what is the cause of this ignorance and the bondage is Matruka. Matruka is Varnamala, about whom we do not know anything. In our scriptures, it's very clearly brought out. There are three aspects about everything. One is the Adi Bhautik, second is Adi Daivik, third is Adhyatmik. And all of them are supported by one common factor called as the Jnanadhishthanam Matruka. Be very attentive. The sun which is hanging in the sky is called as Adi Bhautik sun. The scientists talk about that sun. Then the second sun is the Adi Daivik sun. Adi Daivik sun is the one because of whom the Kunti Mata gave birth to Karna. Adi Daivik sun. The third is the Adhyatmik sun, because of which there is a vision in the eyes. So everything structurally is the Adi Bhautik, functionally is Adi Daivik, and subjective is Adhyatmik. So the structure of the eye is Adi Bhautik, vision is Adi Daivik. Whose vision? My vision, Adhyatmik. Everything has got these three aspects. Similarly, the various letters that we use in writing, A, A, E, E, U, U, etc., they fall in different classes. For example, Pa, Pha, Ba, Bha, Ma. They are called as Pa Varga, starting from Pa. Pa, Pha, Ba, Bha, Ma. They are called as Oshtya or the labials. So, unless the lips are involved, you cannot pronounce pa pa ba bha ma. See, in no language in the world these details are given. Try to say pa pa ba bha ma, keeping your lips apart. Now try to say pa. You cannot. Similarly, dantya, the sounds which involve the teeth, ta, ta, da, dha, na. The tongue has to go and touch the teeth. Now those oldies who do not have the teeth, see how they talk. Because they can't say. So these are the external gross Adi Bhautik. And Adi Daivik is the presiding deity because of whom the meaning to these sounds is given. Adhyatmik, the one who is chanting this. Therefore, every group of letters have their presiding power, presiding deity. And first is the vowels, the class of vowels. A, R, E, E, U, U, A, I, O, O, M, A. Their presiding deity is called as Mahalakshmi. Then the Ka Varga, Ka, Ka, Ga, Ga, the presiding deity is Brahmi. Then the Cha Varga, Cha, Cha, Ja, Ja, Ya, it is the Maheshwari. Then Ta Varga, it is the Kaumari. Then Ta Varga, it is the Vaishnavi. Pa Varga, it is the Varahi. Ya Varga, it is the Aindri or Indrani. And Sa Varga, Sa, Sha, Sa, Sa, Ha, Sha, is the Chamunda. These are the different kinds of potentialities named the divine shaktis, the powers, because of whom the words have their own power. So these are the shaktis which are responsible for covering our knowledge and reducing us to the finite individual. Therefore, all these tantric japas, they have this Bija Mantra, Om Rim Klim Chamundaya Swaha. These are the Bija Mantra, and the Bija, the seeds are responsible for invocation of that kind of potentiality. So all these potentialities are dormant in us. We can invoke them. When a seeker is thus aware of all these subtle details of our personality, and with that he is remaining aware and learning from every experience, not reacting, but learning from every experience, then what happens? Udyamo Bhairavaha. Then suddenly, sometimes, Udyamaha, he is evolved. Udyama doesn't mean efforts. Ud means above, rising up. So, Unmajjanam, he discards all these limitations and gets a flash of his presence. And this flash of presence is Bhairavaha. Bhairava is the pure consciousness. See now, be attentive. When we give importance to the objects indicated by the words, Rasgulla, so we are far away from us. Then from the object we come to the word, Rasgulla. But don't bother about the object. Then we drop the word, come to the tongue, Rasgulla. Where it is chanted, Rasa, how it is chanted, Ra. Sa, Dantya, Ga, Kantya, La, again Dantya, A, Kantya, Rasagulla. From there we come to the mind, heart of Rasagulla. Then we don't get influenced by the thought. So from the object we have come to the Vaikari. From Vaikari we come to the Madhyama, from Madhyama we came to the Pashyanti. And when thus we start remaining in the Pashyanti for longer and longer period, one day by the divine grace it flashes. We give importance to the worldly objects, far away from ourselves. We give importance not to the worldly objects, but the words indicating them, we have come little nearer. Then we drop those words, come to the speech, Vaikari, we have come still nearer. We come to the Madhyama, when we come to Vaikari, stop talking to others, you have conquered Vaikari. Come to Madhyama, stop talking to yourself, you have conquered Madhyama. And you are not yet sleeping. So you have come to the Pashyanti one. Udyamo Bhairavaha. The journey from the gross to the subtle, the journey from experienced to the experiencer to the experiencer, to beyond the trio of experienced, experience and experiencer. This is the journey. Udyamo Bhairavaha. Therefore, अकिंचन चिंतकस्यैव गुरुणा प्रतिबोधितः जायते समावेशः शाम्भवो असौ उदीरितः. Now this experience of yours at this moment, drop the objects, drop the words indicating the objects, that means we stop talking about the world, we have come back, then we keep on chattering with ourselves, stop that. Now, most of us will go to sleep. Don't go to sleep. We have come to Pashyanti Vani. Pashanti Vani is we are not sleeping, but we are not awake also to the world. If we are sleeping, we are lost in matter. If we are awake to the world, we are lost to the manifest matter. But when we are neither awake to the manifest matter, nor we are sleeping, lost in the unmanifest matter, but we are at the junction here, the matter is transcended. This experience is mentioned as Jayate Yas Samaveshaha. This experience Samavesh, this is called as Prayer. The mind will not keep quiet, because unless there is a movement, changes, mind cannot exist. Movement of the water keeps the river, and when the water becomes stagnant, the river disappears. And if the river becomes stagnant in a small pool of water, that water starts rotting. But when the same river merges in the ocean, ocean is nothing but stagnant water. But it is infinite stagnancy. And because it is infinite, there is movement without a movement. The movement of the water in the ocean is not to reach anywhere. But the movement of the river water is to reach somewhere. He Tukaram Maharaj says, Anandache Dohi Ananda Taranga. It is the bliss that is manifesting as a movement in the ocean. Therefore, Udyamo Bhairavaha. Such a person is ever cheerful and happy. Because now through him, no more an individual is expressing. Now through him, the infinite is expressing in its full glory. Atmano bhairavam rupam bhavayet yastu purushah tasya mantra prasidyanti nitya yuktesya sundari. Shivji tells Parvatiji, in this manner, he who is atmanaha bhairava rupam yaha bhavayati, he who is thus, see, it is so simple. Play. Meditation, meditation. Don't do meditation. Play meditation, meditation. Like the children play home, home. They don't become mother, father, but they play. In the same manner, don't become a meditator. If you become a meditator, you'll become serious. Don't disturb. Meditation in progress. No sound. Why? As if you are going to be, you know, subjected to hanging after 5 minutes. No, friends. Just play. And when we play, an individual personality is not born. Be very attentive. When individual personality is not born, in that play, you don't become anybody, and because you don't become anybody, you don't lose, you don't gain. And when we don't lose and don't gain, then what is the fun in playing? Time pass. That's it. Lead to live in this world only for time pass, that's it. There is no achievement, there is no failure. There is no friend, there is no enemy. There is no victory, there is no defeat. Life is lived through without somebody being born. In this manner, this experience is called as realization. Don't imagine. One day, whatever Swamiji, I got to realize, but after that, hordes of problems. What problem, my dear realized one? The problems are, I was wanting to go out of my room and went and dashed against the wall. Why? Everything is Brahman. I cannot differentiate between the wall and the door. These are the tragedies of realization. This is not the meaning, friends. It is something like this. When you sit in the car and look at the road, and the car is moving fast, you will see the road running in the opposite direction. Although you know the road doesn't run, yet when you look at the road, it will be seen as if running. So although we see it is running, we don't accept it is running. Exactly the same way. Although the world will continue to exist and seen as it is, but earlier we have given a status of reality to this world. Now the status of reality which was awarded to this world, the status of reality will disappear. That's why, you know, many seekers, they are unable to continue on this path only because of this. Either, so to be an extremist is very easy. Either get involved too much or go to sleep. In between, neither involved in the world nor sleeping. That is why many people, when they come to satsang, they are unable to hold themselves because they have lived only in two extremes. Either dynamically involved in this world or go to sleep. But there is in between where the waking state has concluded, but the sleep has not begun. Sa sandhi sadhito yena. He who is able to hold on to this junction between manifestation and unmanifestation, he has caught the right point. Therefore, in our scriptures, the sandhya time is very auspicious. Morning sandhya, the night has not yet ended and the day has not yet begun. Early morning, 4 o'clock, 3:30, there is called as prata sandhya. Sayam sandhya, the day has not concluded and the night has not yet begun or ready to begin, that evening sandhya. So when we are able to observe and give importance to the morning and evening sandhya outside, then we understand the importance of the junction. Then you come to subject to experience. A thought has come. Sri Ram. Second thought has not yet begun. So the gap between the first thought and the second thought is called as the sandhi, junction. Sa sandhi sadhito yena. He who is able to hold on to this first thought has died. Sri Ram. Second thought has not begun. That junction. Hold on. If we are not aware, the moment the mind is let, thought free, in no time we go to sleep. Because of the practice. Okay, Maharaj. Evam jagati parimprati pratibha unmesha avashtabha upayikam hairva samapatim ajnanam bandham prashamayika hetum pradarsha etat paramarcha prakarshan vithanam api prashantam eva avabhasam bodhitya. Now, continuing the thought further, shakti chakra sandhane vishwa samharaha. See? Now, be attentive. When words are heard by others, like I am talking to you, this is called as Vaikari Vani. When the words are not heard by others, but we hear our own chattering, that is called as Madhyama Vani. In Vaikari Vani, the object and the word indicating the object, they are separate. Like book is the word and what is in my hand is the book. They are separate. That is called a Vaikari Vani in the waking state. Then secondly, Madhyama Vani, where the word and object indicated by the word, both of them are only thoughts. Like we imagine, after the lecture is over, I am going to have a nice nap. Enough of this lecture. So, we keep on talking to ourselves, nobody is listening to us. There both the nap and actual sleep is only the thought, Madhyama Vani. Third is the Pashyanti Vani, where the thought and object, they are not yet separated, but they are ready to separate. To understand this, when you take the horse gram, it is very hard. If you put and want to chew, your teeth will come out. So hard it is. Then we put it into the water overnight. Then it swells. So, the cotyledons have not yet separated, but they are ready to separate. That stage is called as the Pashyanti Vani. So here, this journey is Shakti Chakra Sandhane, Anusandhane. We inquire, we find out how these potentialities are initiated. So we drop the objective word, we come to the thoughts about the objective word, then we drop the thoughts, we come to the undivided mind. Our mind is divided into knower and known, enjoyer and enjoyed. This division of the mind into the dichotomy of knower known is dissolved. Then we have come to the Paravani, the origin. So this is called as Shakti Chakra Sandhane Anusandhane Vishwa Samharaha. When we go back to the Paravani, the world ceases to exist. That doesn't mean the world will disappear. Be very attentive. The mirage waters, when they are seen by the animals run to drink that mirage waters. But when we see the mirage, we don't run to get that water, because although it is appearing, we know it is not real. Exactly, for the wise man, although the experiences of the relative world appear to be, yet he is not influenced by any one of them. Therefore, Bhagavan says, Name Dveshosi Na Priyaha. Suppose in the dream, you have seen one enemy who came to kill you, and then one friend who came and who protected you from the enemy, and when you wake up, will you have hatred for the enemy in the dream or the love for the friend in the dream? Because you are awakened from that. Exactly the same way. When we awaken to our essential nature, and the technique is Shakti Chakra Sandhane. We start the Anusandhana, following step by step. First, importance is given to the objects. Then importance is given to the instrument of the object. Then importance is given to the experience of the object. Then importance is given to the experiencer of the object. See the step by step. Chakri Chakra Sandhana. If there is no experienced object, then there cannot be an experiencer. So the experience without the experiencer is our essential nature. This technique also I told you, try this sincerely. Make absence as an object of your knowledge. Absence is always of something. Absence is not an object. So sound is the object. Sri Ram. Now make the absence of this sound as the object of knowledge. Ears are open. They want to hear. But there is no sound. So what is happening? Hearing without heard. And because there is no object to hear, hearer, experiencer is not born. But the experience is there. Now give it a try. Focus your attention on the absence of the sound, not the sound. Sri Ram. Sri Ram. Sri Ram. So when hearing is happening, but there is nothing to hear, therefore hearer is not born. So hearing without a hearer and a heard is God principle. But most of us get lost only in the silence. We don't like any disturbance. There should be silence, silence. Don't run here and there. Observe silence. That is not the truth. The truth is that which is supporting the sound, that which is supporting the silence and yet is beyond the influence of the sounds and the silence, that is our essential nature. Shakti Chakra, Shakti Chakra Sandhane Vishwa Samharaha. Then the world may be there, it is of no consequences to us. Such a master lives in this very world without getting influenced by anything in this world. If somebody says that I have never committed any accident by car, oh, very good. But how come you achieved this thing? I never drive. Then it is not great. If you are driving and yet you don't commit an accident, then you are a genius driver. If you never drive and say, I have never committed an accident, what is the great thing about it? Friends, the spiritual life is not going somewhere in the forest and hiding behind a cave. No. See? We have to remain in this dynamic world and yet we do not allow the world to touch us. See? when you cut, you know, the jackfruit, here, because of the juice or something coming out of that jackfruit, your hands become very sticky. So there is a technique. Apply oil. After you apply oil, then you cut, then it did not become sticky. In the same manner, live in this world, but apply the wisdom oil. And live very much in this world. We don't have to go anywhere. Because the world is not outside, the world is in our mind only. And when the mind is dissolved, the world cannot touch us. Therefore, here, Shakti Chakra Sandhane Vishwa Samharaha. So, disappearance of the world does not mean the world will disappear, but the status of reality that we have given to the world, that status of reality will disappear. This disappearance is like this. Take an example. When we look at the sky without any clouds, we see the sky blue. But we have studied physics and we know sky does not have any color. Although we know sky doesn't have any color, yet when we look up in the sky, we see the blue color. So what is our understanding? We may call blue sky, yet we know the sky does not have any color. So the blueness of the sky will not be of any consequence to us. Had it been any consequential, then we like to paint it with some other color. But it doesn't happen because we know the blueness of the sky is merely an appearance. It is not real. In the same manner, this world, friends and enemies, nears and dears, achievement and failures, these are merely appearances. You don't remove them, let them be there, how does it matter? The moment we want to change something, we have given a status of reality. If somebody wants to change the color of the sky, no, I don't like blue's color. I believe in the woman's lip. Woman is what? Pink color. Let there be sky only pink, not blue. And spend lot of money on that. Because you have given a status of reality to the color of the sky. But when you know the color of the sky is merely an appearance, he will not struggle to do anything with it, but on the contrary, will enjoy the way it is. Same thing horizon. Horizon is not an object. It only appears as if the dome of the sky is touching the ground. But where the sky is not touching the ground, everywhere. See, friends. The more we contemplate and reflect, we come to know that this world is merely an appearance. And no appearance can exist without the substratum. And when we come to discover the substratum as our essential nature, Shakti Chakra Sandhane Vishwa Samharaha, the world will disappear. Means the world will no more be taken as real. Like on the stage, the actor doesn't take the character that he is playing as real, he is only acting. So even if he is a criminal, he is only acting, he is not a criminal. You remember when Mahabharata serial was going on and when the Shakuni Mama used to come on the screen, people used to say, oh God, this fellow has come, now he will play some mischief. But that doesn't mean that character who was playing Shakuni was a bad person. But his performance was so perfect that everybody thought he is really a bad person. In the same manner, play the role, whatever we have to play, and hold on to the foundation. Shakti Chakra Sandhane Vishwa Samharaha. Then this world will no more be a botheration for us. This is the only way. Now, this doesn't mean that this experience remains only when we are sitting in the satsang or during meditation. No. For us, meditation is half an hour meditation and the rest of the day frustration. That is not meditation. We live 24/7 in meditation. Defense. And therefore, here the teacher says in next sutra, Jagrat Swapna Sushupta Bhede Turiya Bhoga Sambhavaha. Now, this Turiya, Turiya means the fourth, be very attentive. This is another point where many people get confused. Jagrat number one, Swapna number two, Sushupti number three. Waking, dream, deep sleep, three. And therefore, fourth. But that doesn't mean this is fourth. It means this is the only one on which the gross body identification creates an illusion of the waker with the waking world. The subtle body identification creating the dream world with the dreamer is the second stage. And their absence in the conditioning superimposed on the absolute one then create the deep sleep. Like one man, he is called as father, he is called as husband, he is called as son. So, father number one, husband number two, son number three. Who is this man? Man, he is the fourth one. Is he fourth one? So, one man alone is referred as three because of the three conditioning. In the same manner, Turiya Bhoga Sambhavaha, this experience of abidance in the absolute is not limited for a limited moment of the waking, but this is a continuous unbroken experience in and through waking, dream, deep sleep and samadhi. Turiya Bhoga Sambhavaha. See, friends. Now for this, what spiritual practice you tell me can be prescribed? For the husband to know that he is man, what practice he should do? Take the mala in the hand. I am not the husband. Actually, I am the man. I am not the husband. Okay? I am actually man. Not husband, man. I am pure man. Will you do the japa? Then what practice? Don't take wife seriously. That's it. But when we take the wife seriously, throughout life we only suffer. See, friends. And the one who suffers, Mr. Husband, he is nowhere. Find out where is the husband on your body. Like a mosquito sitting somewhere. When the mosquito bites, you can kill him. When the husband bites the man, what can you do? See? So we are all miserable because of that which doesn't exist. See, friends, the more you become clear about this, therefore, Jagra Swapna Sushupta Bhede Turiya Abhoga Sambhavaha. This experience is no more limited only for a particular moment. See? Otherwise, you know, like we people, while giving the lecture, Aham Brahmasmi. See? I am Brahman. I am Brahman. After the lecture is over, I am Brahma. I am deluded. While giving the lecture, Yagi Naike Amritatva Manasho. Renounce everything if you want the reality. And the moment you get down, Nikaro Paisa. Renounce. See, friends. That is why, you know, Naradji tells in Padma Puran, where Bhagavad is glorified, that in Kali Yuga, the essence of everything is lost. And in that list of everything, the first thing is the satsanga. He says the satsanga essence is lost in Kali Yuga because the Bhagavad Katha is not done for the Bhagavan, but it is done for a fundraiser. How there can be divinity manifested? Because the purpose is not Bhagavan, the purpose is funds. And why funds? We have to do something. Who asks you? See, friends, if we are sincerely walking the spiritual path, no thought about the world will ever cross in our mind. And then all good that happens, it is just a byproduct. And when there is a byproduct, we don't buy a cow for the quantity of cow dung she gives. We buy a cow on the basis of the quantity of milk she gives, not cow dung. Anyway, it will come, don't worry. In the same manner, goodness to the world will happen, who cares? See? But when we do goodness to the world, again I is born. I have done so much for the world, but the world doesn't recognize me. Who asks you? Who? Therefore, in this, etat jagradadi trayam sutra trena lakshati. So now these three experiences, jagrat, sapna, sushupti, in and through these, the only absolute reality is recognized without any blemish. What are these three experiences? Jagrat, sapna, sushupti. Here, the definition of the jagrat, sapna, sushupti which is given is unparalleled. Nowhere you come across. Jnanam jagrat, sapno vikalpaha, avivego maya saushuptam. Jagrat avastha is that where the knowledge is gathered by coming in contact with the worldly objects. Jagrat is that when we are identified with the gross body. Now this jagrat avastha is of four types. Jagrat jagrat, jagrat sapna, jagrat sushupti and jagrat turiya. Four. Similarly, the sapnavastha, the dream state, that is also sapna sapna, sapna jagrat, sapna sushupti and sapna turiya. So is the case with the sushupti avastha. Sushupti jagrat, sushupti sapna, sushupti sushupti, sushupti turiya. And when it comes turiya, it is only jagrat, turiya, then turiya sapna, turiya sushupti, there is no turiya turiya. In this manner, these are 14, 15 states of experiences we go through. This is the Purnamasi, 15 days. And Shodashakala Purushaha and Paramatma is the 16th one. So which are these states? One example I'll give you, then rest you can work on it. Jagrat jagrat means that experience where the objects of the world are given more importance in our experience. House should be like that, curtain should be like that, furniture should be like that, road should be like that, they should be clean, government is not working. So when the objects of the world are more important, it is jagrat jagrat, absolute solid rubbish. Then second is jagrat sapna. Then we are all the time talking about our experiences. When we went to their house, the food was so good, you know, it was very nice, tasty food. So the food is not there, but the experience of that, or when we went to that place, it was so nice, clean, quiet place. When we give importance to the experiences, it is jagrat sapna. Then jagrat sushupti. When we give importance to the I have done this thing, I have done that thing, I enjoyed, I suffered, jagrat sushupti. And jagrat turiya means we are living in this world, but we are not getting influence anywhere, neither in the worldly objects, nor experiences of the objects, nor the experiencer. We remain in a total witness position. Jagrat Purusha. Get these points across. Three things we give importance, either the object of experience, or the experience of the object, or the experiencer of the object. If these three things are discarded, then what remains is the absolute conscious blissful existence, which is permeating in and through, but which is not yet influenced by any one of them. This is the Jagrat Avastha. So the waking state demands the objective world for the experiences to happen. But in the dream state, we don't require the objective world. We create our own things there. So the objects are created by the mind. The experiences are gathered by the same mind. The experiencer is also created by the same mind. So the same mind has become three. It has become the experienced object, it has become the experiencer of the object, it has become the experiencer of the object. It is only at the level of the thoughts. And in Sushupti Avastha, absence of the waking and the dream. So, Jagra Sapna Sushupti Bhede, when their secret is understood, in and through all of them, there is but one Turya Abhoga Sambhavaha, there is certainly a positive possibility of remaining in that absolute conscious blissful existence in spite of various clouds of waking, dream and deep sleep come and go. It doesn't make any difference to us. In this manner, Jnanam Jagrat Sapna Vikalpaha and Sushupti is Maya Saushuptam. In Sushupti Avastha, in deep sleep, we are in a state of utter ignorance. No discrimination. Neither we know ourselves, nor we know the world, nor we know the God, nor we know the functioning of the mind. No, nothing. A state of aviveka, lack of any discrimination. In this manner, in and through all the experiences, there is but one reality that is functioning, and that is our essential nature. After having said this, when a person thus comes to this experience, Turya Abhoga Sambhavaha, then what is his status? What is his experience like? This is the next topic which we will take in our tomorrow's class. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnahat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.